working out is essential to preventing injury and getting the most out of the exercise and your workout. When you do your lower body exercises, having the correct alignment of your spine and proper knee tracking will make all the difference in the exercise. It'll prevent injury as well. So I'd like to go over some lower body exercises with the squat, the lunge, and the lateral lunge to help improve your form the next time you do your lower body exercises. The first exercise I'd like to go over with proper form is the squat. It's one of the most fundamental exercises and you need to know how to do it properly so that you prevent the injury and get the most out of the movement. So this is what I see whenever an improper movement is formed. Now don't do this at home. The knees will drop forward, which creates a lot of knee shearing. The knees might actually even wobble in, and then the spine tucks under, and I see a lot of this coming forward. The heels will also come up off of the ground. So you want to make sure that you really realign the spine and your form from the ground up. You do this by keeping a nice stable base, press the hips back, keep the chest lifted, press into the heels as you lower down, keeping the knees back behind the toes, the chest is lifted, not hinging forward, and then you stand back up. So I like to place my hands back behind my head so that it keeps my chest lifted and reminds me to stay open. So as we do this again, we press back, the weight is into my heels, not my toes. Knees are back behind my toes and they're in the same line tracking as my big toe and my pinky toe. As I go down, I'm pressing the hips back, keeping the torso lifted and pulling the shoulders back, and then I stand back up. So now we're going to take this squat onto your total gym to do the same type of form. So now I have the incline at the highest level. You'll place your feet onto the squat stand. Now everybody's body position, limb length is different, so you want to make sure that you're accommodating for your height and size. So you'll press down into the squat positioning, lowering your legs so that the knees are in the same line as your toes, pressing through the glutes, keeping your hips at the bottom of the glide board, and then press back with control. As you do this, you want to make sure that you're not rocking through or your hips are coming off or you're coming down too low. If you feel any type of knee pain whenever you go into that movement, you need to adjust your feet either higher or lower or wider to accommodate for any type of knee pain. So it's very easy to perfect your form on the glide board because it keeps your spine in that nice position. But whenever you come off and do a freestanding squat, make sure that you align the toes, keep the chest lifted, press the hips back, and really focus on the alignment of your spine. Next, I'd like to go over the lunge. The lunge is also a fundamental exercise that you really need to have proper form with so that you can advance it into different variations and prevent injury, especially in the knee. When you do the lunge improperly, usually the knee will hinge inward, creating a lot of medial knee strain. Your spine will be off and your posture is all wrong, creating an improper lunge. So when we go into a proper lunge, I'd like you to start on the ground so that you can really perfect that movement with a stable surface. So I'm into a kneeling position with both knees, one knee down and one leg lifted. So I have two 90 degree angles. I'm going to press the weight into my front heel and into my back toe as I lift the knee off the ground. That puts me right into a proper form of the lunge. So with that 90 degree position in the front as well as the back, and you want the knee to track in between the big toe and the small toe, and then you can stand straight up. So you can perfect this by staying stationary before you add any type of dynamic movement. Same thing as we take this exercise onto your total gym. You'll have a low incline, and you'll come into that low kneeling position, having one right angle in the front as well as into the back. As you lift the knee off of the glide board, you're already in a position that you have the weight into your heel and the knee is tracking between the big toe and the small toe. As you lower down into your lunge and stand back up, really focus on the proper alignment of your spine as well as your knees. So you want to really control the motion, and if you need to, you can hold on to something to keep your balance. But it's really great to perform this with the total gym because the glide board allows you to move freely through the motion so that you can really focus on the front leg. So that is how you perfect form when doing the lunge. And the last exercise we'll go over is the lateral lunge. It's so very important to perfect this exercise because if you do it improperly, you're putting a lot of strain on the knee and improve posture. So when we go into a lateral lunge, you want to step out to the side. It doesn't have to be a wide stance, but you want to make sure that your nose, your knee, and your toe are in the same alignment while the other leg is straight and both feet are facing forward. So your hips are hinging back as you go in through this and keeping your chest lifted, and then you can stand straight up. So we can stay stationary, really perfect that movement as we shift the body weight to one side, really overloading our leg, pressing the weight into our heels and activating through our glutes and hamstrings as we stand. And then we can add dynamic movement where we're stepping out and stepping back in. So now let's take that same exercise to your total gym. Again, we'll have the incline at a low level, standing at the bottom base. You'll take one foot onto your glide board and open it up. You'll bend that knee as we just did, keeping your nose, your knee, and your toe in the same alignment. You'll press the hips back and keep the weight into your heel, and then you'll stand back up. So this leg is just coming along for the ride. You're feeling the stretch on the inner thigh, but you're also activating and keeping that stability, especially in the standing leg. So you really want to make sure that you're not shifting the body weight over, because if you do that, you can put strain on the groin and the inner thigh. So really focus on keeping the alignment of where your body goes, the proper tracking of the knee in all these different angles and positions, and you'll have a perfect lateral lunge. So those were some examples of improper form for lower body exercises. As you can see, it is so very important to have proper form to prevent injury and to really get the most out of your exercises. So think form first before adding more, and you will get the best workout possible.